we'll be
so now we'll be carrying out the experiment of calibration of slip gauge, calibration of micrometer using slip gauge. So we know that the slip gauge is used as the end standard. So you can see a standard slip gauge box here, where you have different gauge thickness. So randomly I have picked 10 mm gauge thickness. So you are already familiar with the screw gauge. I'll be just slightly touching up the basics. So this is the anvil. So this is the movable anvil. This is the fixed anvil. So where the specimen is placed. So you can measure thickness of in microns using the screw gauge. So basically you have one circular scale, one pitch scale. Okay. So the circular scale here is having 50 divisions. So the pitch scale reads in mm. So now for calibration purpose, I am taking a 10 mm slip gauge thickness and I am placing it between the anvils. So once this is done, we have to make sure that even the screw gauge reads 10 mm. Zoom. So you can see that here it is reading 10 mm. So it says that the measurement using micrometer is exactly correct. So if this is showing some error, if the zero of the circular, if the zero of the circular scale is not coinciding with the pitch scale, then we say that it has an error. So we have a calibrating lever. So this is the calibrating lever. So which is held inside the hole here, and you can just rotate the pitch scale through a certain angle so that the zero of the circular scale and pitch scale coincides. So this is how you basically calibrate micrometer using slip gauge. Thank you.